speaker for this afternoon's protest, and it's Oktay Sahbaz from the Turkish and Kurdish Community Center, Day-Mer.
Thank you. Hello, friends. Oktay here from Day-Mer, the Turkish and Kurdish Community Center. We send our solidarities to our brothers and sisters in America who have been fighting the fascists. Now, we have a fascist in our own country. His name is Recep Tayyip Erdogan. And guess what? He was one of the first leaders to go and visit Trump when he was elected. So he kind of shows a mentality. Now, what Trump is trying to do in America is what Erdogan is trying to do in Turkey. You know, he's attacking the working class people. You know, he's making their lives miserable. He's arresting journalists. He's arresting teachers. You know, he's arresting academics. And, you know, he's fighting. You know, he's having a go at the working class people full on. And to stop people coming together, you know, he's creating divisions. He's creating divisions between communities, Armenians, the Kurds, the Turks, and so on. And he's trying to create almost a sense of almost a civil war. I mean, Turkey, if Turkey goes into some sort of a civil war in the next 2-3 years, you know, that shouldn't surprise you. And what we're seeing, that same model being replicated around Europe and also in America and other parts of the world. The working class people are being attacked. Their rights, you know, their rights for a decent life, their rights for decent jobs, you know, for different decent public services. And we are seeing fascism creeping up. We are seeing these evil people trying to divide communities, have a go at communities of all kinds using fascism and having a go at each other. You know, they're not interested in us coming together and standing for decent jobs, for a decent future, this education. They are trying to create all that. And what we have to do is, you know, we need to see that this is also capitalism struggling. The capitalism can, you know, is under pressure. It's quite obvious that when it starts attacking like this, when it starts showing its most brutal sides to people, it means it's suffering. But what we have to do, you know, we have to make sure that it doesn't just suffer, but it goes, it finishes. Yeah. So what we need to do is we need to raise, you know, and we need to bring that sense of unity, that togetherness. You know, as Wayman said, you know, we were able to smash EDL, smash BNP in this country. You know, and I'm very proud that this country has a, you know, a strong history of smashing all these racist and fascists. But that sense of, you know, beating the fascists and the racists and kicking them out of the streets need to grow. And as Chris said, we need to make sure that gets bigger and bigger and bigger so that these people don't have any space on our streets, on our communities. But we need to do that, you know, but we need more people involved. You know, yes, stand up to racism, stop the war. These are very crucial campaign groups. But we need to see the trade unions here. We need to see the political parties here. You know, racism and fascism is not just the issue, it's not our issue. It should be the issue of the trade unions, the political parties. They should all be very clear on this. Yes, we could have a go at Theresa May, but we need to see who our real friends and who are really standing with. So, in that sense, let's make that solidarity bigger. Let's kick the fascists out. Solidarity, brothers and sisters.